Well, good morning, everybody. I've just had my cornflakes and soy milk because I'm on soy milk now. This is obviously keeping me nice and fit and healthy for today. Anyway, where am I? I'm at Harescombe Fishery in Gloucester. I'm doing something I don't particularly like doing, and that's not work. This is work, actually, today. I'm actually filming a live match. So we are at Harescombe Fishery. I'm on the new lake. We're doing the draw in about, I think it's about 15, 20 minutes with Zolt. Zolt's going to be the cameraman today. Like I said, it's not the greatest thing that I do because obviously it's winter time and the fishing can be tough for some and fantastic for others. But we are on the new lake. I'm actually, the draw here where I am now is actually on the old part of the complex. And they built this new lake. I fished it once. And it was really, really good. But some people did struggle. I'm not making excuses, by the way, because that is winter fishing. But it's only stocked with silverfish. So it's stocked with bream, roach, hybrid. I caught a hybrid about 3 pounds about 2 weeks ago, which is a massive bonus fish, really. There's a few perch and bits and pieces in there, but mainly bream and skimmers. So that's what today's all about. I'm going to go, as I said, do the draw in about 20 minutes with Zolt, and we'll hopefully draw a good peg out. It will be up and down, I'm sure. The weather's been good. It's about, what is it, about 8 degrees this morning, and we've had a couple of days of like 10, 11 degrees, which is what you want this time of year, because I think everybody, hopefully, the fish will spread out a little bit, and everybody will get a few bites. So bear with us, and I'll get back to you when I'm doing the draw, and they'll all be ripping into me like they always do here. So we'll have a bit of banter and a bit of laugh on, you know, through the whole match and through the film. So speak to you in a bit. Bye. Well, you've come on the camera just at the right time. I've just had a big bream roll in me peg. So that's a good sign. Let me tell you, a little bit about the lake. It is new. It's been open for some time now, and they've been running matches on. And the fishing's been exceptional. Bream and big skimmers, and then the roach is a sort of a backup. I'm looking to catch bream, really. I'll only be fishing for roach if I really need to. My last match I caught 69 pounds, most of that was bream and skimmers. It's quite a deep lake. It's a top kit plus one in the middle. At the moment I'm just plumbing up on a 13 meter line with me dolly butt on, because I'm treating it a bit like canal fishing. So I'm just as it starts to go up the slope, because that's where I caught last time. I caught very little in the middle, but I know they have been in areas catching the middle, so I'm gonna have to set a rig up for that. But it's about 9 foot deep. All I've got out is 6 slip elastics on all my top kits, nice and simple. And at the moment I've set up a 0.75 power, one of the new natural power floats, with a bulk and 2 number 9 droppers, so it's all nice and positive. But when I take the dolly butt off and put the 14.5 meter piece on, it does come up probably about 2 foot, so I'm also going to set up probably a 4B16 F1 maggot up for that. I thought my depth is probably about 8 foot where I'm fishing, but it's nice. So I'm going to carry on setting a couple of rigs up, and then what I'll do, I'll talk you through when we start, how much ground bait I'm putting in, what I'm putting in my ground bait, what ground bait, and things like that when we get going, because I haven't got much time to get set up.
And then we can talk about baits. You know, what baits I got with me is pretty simple. It's just natural baits, if you like. And so I'll carry on plumbing up. But just to tell you a little bit about the lake, really, that was it. It's quite a deep lake. This is wide where I am. It is different to the peg that I had last time, because last time I had like 8 foot, about 2 meters from the bank. Where I am today, I'm probably only, 4 pegs up from where I drew the other week. And the bottom is completely different. So that's what you've got to put up with when you go fishing. But I'm going to be quite positive. Last time I felt like I should have fished bigger floats for these bream. I should have been lagging on a bit of line. They're probably a little bit green, these fish, but they are getting caught more and more and more. They're holding matches on you 2 times a week or 3 times a week at the moment, which is going to have an effect, as we all know. So I'll set a few more rigs up and I'll get back to you and let you know about everything else that I'm doing. I'm just plumbing up my longer line now. Like I said, it's about 2 foot deeper. 2 foot shallower than my 13 plus the dolly. This is the 14 plus the dolly. And it does plumb up. It's not easy to plumb up, which is what I get asked a lot. But I'm trying to find two areas. One towards the empty peg to me right, and one in front of me. Well, the one in front of me, if you see on my pole there, I've actually put like a little black pen mark. Because you're fishing on a slope, I've actually got that. So it's on my hand there where I hold my pole. So I can mark that out, you can see that. I can just get that off with a bit of ferry, a bit of soapy water. I've probably got several marks on here from where I've been fishing at Tunnel Bard and stuff. But that's what I'm decided to do. I would say it's probably 6 foot there. So it's about 2 foot shallower than the other line. I don't really want to go over any further. I'm not sure whether to actually make a little, because it obviously is still winter time. I might just make a little rig to go over, because if I stretch out like that, it literally comes up 2.5 foot. So there's no shelf there. It's quite aggressive, the slope, which is going to be not great to fish on with ground bait. And that's something else I've got to think about, is when I put my ground bait in, I'm going to have to put it in loose rather than balls, because I'm fishing on that real, quite a steep slope. If I come back a little bit like that, it probably drops off. It's not too bad. It probably drops off probably 1 foot over 2 foot. So it's not horrendous, but it's something that I'm thinking, as soon as I plumbed up, I'm thinking, well, I've got to go really careful how I put my ground bait in. So that's the 14.5 meter line. I'll carry on setting a couple more rigs up, but I thought I'd just run you through that, because that's what a lot of people want to know, is because they go to venues with bad shelves, and when you find a nice little area like I have, mark it with a little marker or a little bit of electrical tape. Just change my hook length. Hook lengths, I'm using an 18 or a 16 SFL to 09, because we are fishing for just silverfish. Like I said, there's no carp in here. There is some big bream. I just hope that the bream are in this area, because that's what you're going to need to actually do any good. And my whole sort of match really is going to be based around catching skimmers in bream, and then a few roach, hopefully mixed in. There's some massive roach in that in here as well. So hopefully they're in this area. Right, we've got about 10 minutes to go. I'm just going to go through my ground bait, because obviously I want to get everything ready, because this is going to be about ground bait and sort of particle baits today. My mix for today, I've mixed up 3/4 of a bag of black, So Natural black roach, 2 pints of dark F1, and about 1 pint of green fatchers. Because last time, that's what I fished. There's a lot of roach in here, and I just felt the crumb-based ground bait, which is what I've been using on a lot of my silverfish matches, has been making a difference. And hopefully And I caught 69 pound every week and they struggled around me. And I think they might have gone down the fish meal road, you know, full on. That's what I thought. That's what I'm doing today. I've got four lines, basically. I've got 10 metres. I've got 13 metres with the dolly butt on. 14 and a half metres, which I've marked with the pole. And I've also just set up a little 4B12 F1 maggot for fishing 16 metres. But the shelf, when you plumb up on that far shelf, it's not easy. And I'll talk you through that a little bit more, you know, whilst we're fishing and what line I'm fishing and how I'm feeding it. Because it is quite, I don't really know it, you know, it's one of them, it's unknown really. And I've only been here once. So anyway, let's sort the ground bait out. So I'm going to get two handfuls. Well, I'm going to put four handfuls in there. Because on me 13 metre line plus the dolly butt, I'm only going to put two balls in. I'm not going to fill it in. Even though there's a lot of bream and skimmers in here, I don't want to overcook it. We are in winter. We've just come out of some really, really cold weather. So, you know, so that's the sort of things I'm thinking about. So in there, I'm going to put just a sprinkle of casters, a sprinkle of dead maggots. It's just a bit of everything, really. But what I'm going to do is put a big handful of pinkies, fluoro pinkies. So I'm going to make four balls out of that, and that's going to cover me for two lines. I've actually fished. And one nice little thing that I'll point out is when I've plumbed up a line long, I've gone out there to see if my rig's right, and I'm looking to see where the toe's going. You've got to watch that. And my spare peg is to the right. Unfortunately for me, the toe is going right to left. And I know probably because it's silverfish fishing, I'm going to have to wait for bites today. It's not going to be in and out. Well, hopefully it's going to be in and out with lots of fish. But if I was to fish to my right, which is going up in the toe, I would be dropping my pole in like that, and my float would be coming under my pole tip like that. And I know from past experience, that's going to make it really, really awkward. I haven't gone to my right at the moment. What I've done is fishing out in front of me and to my left, because obviously that's going downstream, if you like, which is a lot easier and better for presentation. I'm obviously watching the guy to my right, to my left, sorry. He's not gone right over. So that might be a bit of advantage for me. So anyway, let's get that mixed up. So that's the 13 and a half meter line, or 13 meter line plus the dolly. And I've also set up a 10 meter line. Now, I'm not going to put a lot of bait in there at the start because I want to start there. I'm just going to plonk a little bit of ball in, see what happens, and I might put some more bait in when I come off of it. But I need to start somewhere, and I feel like I need to start at 10 metres. I've seen a couple of fish top, which hopefully they'll go down, and I'm just going to make one ball in there, and I'm just going to put a little bit of pink in, a little bit of caster. Nothing really, literally probably like 30 casters and twice as many pinkies. So like that. So that's me 10 meter line, which I'm going to be starting on. And then I've got me 14 and a half meter line, which I think could possibly be my best line, but I'm not going to put any balls in there at all. I'm actually going to put three loose pots of ground bait. One, two, three. So I'm going to put that in. Again, few particles, not loads. Even though I'm putting it in loose, I still put my particles in it. Because as soon as I plumb up on that slope, I thought if I put a ball in there, I'm not going to know where it's going to end up. It's going to be like down the shelf, could land anywhere. And I thought if I put it in loose, then it's going to spread over the shelf. The bream and skimmers are hopefully going to come along and sort of settle over that, pick little bits off the shelf. Because last time I come, most of the fish I caught, I actually caught on the slope. Even though it plumbed up better than this peg, but I caught most of my fish on the slope, and the people that didn't fish over far enough didn't really catch a lot. It might be different today, perhaps the fish would be settled in the middle, but I'm covering that anyway. And that's it, that's me three. I've got three EVA bowls. That's something, you know, that's something I do, one for each little line, because in there I know what I'm doing. I've got enough ground bait there then to top up. So that's me fire line. That's me one. Obviously I'm going to feed my 10 meter line first before I feed anything else, because that's where I'm going to start. So that's it, I'm ready to go. Rig wise, nice and easy. I've got two 0.75 power floats, one for 13 meters maybe dolly butt, one for 10 meters because unfortunately it's a bit deeper and I don't really like messing around with floats. When I've set them, I'd just rather make another rig up. Like I said, it is top kit plus one, so it's quite deep. It's quite a deep lake. It's quite nice, actually. It's quite nice for you guys, because we all know most commercials nowadays are all sort of 4 to 6 foot deep, where this is slightly different. And then my 14.5 plus the dolly, I've got a 4B16 F1 maggot. And then I have set up a little 4B12, just in about another 18 inches less than what I have got at 14.5. I know it sounds a bit confusing, but don't worry about that too much, because when I get going, I'll talk you through what rigs and what we're feeding, etc., etc., if we catch anything. So fingers crossed, we've literally got 2 minutes. So I'm gonna turn around now and get ready to start the match. There we go, so that's all in. So because of me live pink is in there, I've not actually made the balls up yet. I'm gonna make them up now. So that's me 10 meter line. Bit of a rush for me, to be honest, but there you go. So 10 meters that is, that's me one ball. That's where I'm gonna start. And I'll look round and see if I have started in the right area. So 10 meters, I'm not gonna take them 2 seconds off. Smack in front of me. Like that. Now I've got my 13 meter dolly butt on. 13 meter section plus my dolly butt. Which is me 4 balls, because I've got 2 lines going on that distance. And with me live pinkies in there, you're probably better off making a couple of balls up, potting them in, and making a couple more up again, because obviously you lose all your pinkies out of your ground bait. So that's me 13 metre line, which is the bottom of the shelf. But with me dolly, that's what's so nice about them dollies. When I put the dolly on, it just felt I was just going up that shelf a little bit. So smack in front of me there. Said it might take a while. There was a few, when I come 2 weeks ago, there was people that caught straight away. I didn't, it took me an hour to catch. So that's one line in front of me, and I've got another line just to cover me options, really. Because I'm thinking to myself, if the 13 meter line is good, and I need to go, and they're in that depth of water, or in that area of the lake, I can go between the two 13 meter lines. Where fishing on that shelf at 14.5 on angles ain't gonna be easy. So I got myself lined up with a guy opposite, down to my left a bit. It is going towards the peg, but I'm not fussed about that. It's just covering me options. It's probably about 4 meters away from the other line. Whatever happens, we'll have a nice day, and you know, whether we compete or not, we will see. So let's put me 14.5 meter piece on a minute. But I need me dolly on there, because I got me little black mark on there that I showed you, which is there. A little bit of take in, I know, but that's what you've got to do on some of these winter matches. Just get them out of the way. So this is the line I'm gonna put in just loose. Just pat that down so it don't come out on the way out. I'd love to have put proper little balls in there, but with that shelf, just didn't like it at all when I plumbed up. So I've got my little black mark pen there. Smack in front of me again. You can always push it out a little bit further because you are on a shelf. Look at that, beautiful that. slightly damp for a ground bait, because obviously we wanted to get it down. There's a lot of, quite a lot of crumb in that mix. So you never know how this is going to fish. The match reports here go up and down. 1 minute they're 40, 50 pounds, 1 minute they're 15, 16. So you never know. Yeah, that's quite a lot of bait, that. It's quite three big
tubs.
Three big potfuls. Nice to be quite aggressive, because I go to venues and this won't work. You know, some of the venues I go to, you've got to be feeding like little thimble size pieces of ground bait. That's the main long line, if you like. So I'm going to start at 10 metres. Not sure what's going to happen, but we'll see. I'm going to start on double fluoro pinky. Pretty negative, but I think if there's a fish or two about, they'll be straight on that. A 0.75 rig, quite positive. I will throw some maggots over the top of that. And that's quite flat there. I can actually take a section off. If I start loose feeding, if there's a few roach feeding and they don't really want to be over the ground bait, I can even drop a bit shorter over a bit of loose feed. Well, this is my first bite, but it wasn't a bite. It's actually foul hooked. Well, I would apologise for that, but great big, nice big bream. But I had a little indication before that. So, a little bit of luck like that always comes in handy. I just flick my rig past me bait and let it sort of come back onto it as well then. So I'm just going to start catapulting a few maggots over the top rather than casters. I just fancy maggots. I caught a lot of fish on maggots last time. And I think with the roach and that in here, so I've plumbed up at the moment, just normal, body sort of just over an inch out of the water. I can always vary that. If I get indications and I can't catch, I can put a little bit more line on the bottom. But we've only been going 10 minutes, so, you know, so basically I'm trying to rest them long lines. I don't want to go over there just yet. I know some people have gone, they've gone over. And there has been a couple of fish caught over, like roach, I think. But what I'm hoping is the bream, the skimmers, you know, if they're in the area, they're going to settle. Because that's what you're going to need, I think. You're going to need a good weight, I think. And he's got a skimmer to my right. But when I seen him plumb up to my right, it looks like he's got a lot more depth tighter over to the island than what I got, which is what I had 2 weeks ago. Well, I got another fish on now. Double pinky. Not sure what I've actually had a fouled up bream. Little skimmer. Nice size skimmer, eh? So that's over that one ball. He's nailed that as well. Let me disgorge right. Nice little 6-8 ounce skimmer. Just gonna take one of my little adjustment shot off there. Just that wind's just sort of blowing over towards me. Bit of an awkward angle, really. It's just pushing the float down. But this is a sort of venue where you can start using your natural floats, even though it is a commercial, because of the depth. And it does get windier. Last time I come, the wind, literally within 10 minutes, was like proper strong. And that's why I've sort of opted for these natural floats. Just fire a few maggots over the top, a little bit shorter over the top of me float there. It's just got a slight skim right to left, which is quite nice really, because it is blowing into the wind. You know, we've only just started, there's a few fish coming out. I've seen a few net fish. And obviously it's always in my mind, you know, topping up. I've learnt a little bit last time that topping up was important, but sometimes you had to top up and leave it. They weren't always sort of coming straight to your bait. You sort of had to top it up, get away from it. And that's why you have several lines going, because if it is a day like that, it's important you have a few lines going. I think it will depend on where the bream and skimmers are caught for the big weights. You know, it is winter and they will be in certain areas. And last time, to be fair, last time I was along this bit, 2 weeks ago, there weren't many roach caught along this area. There was lots of roach caught opposite. I think some guy had 30 odd pound of roach, which is, you know, amazing winter fishing. But they weren't everywhere. I caught some roach, but not many. My whole match was based around skimmers, odd bream, but mostly big skimmers really, which was you know, amazing fishing. I always have a little scan round as well, have a little look, you know what I mean, see where people are fishing. See what they're catching. Not too much, mind, because I'm concentrating on what I'm doing. Well, I've got another skimmer on now. Probably 10 minutes after I spoke to you. Just changed over to a single red maggot. So I caught a couple of little roach on pinkies and I thought, well, I'll just put a maggot on. I know that's a bit weird, but that's what goes through my mind. I think I'll just try it. And that's a result. So that's great. To catch a few fish like that early. Look at that. Harescombe skimmer. You know, always respect your fish, you know, put them in the nets and stuff, because it's really important. You want to come back the next week and do it all again. So I'm just loose feeding a few maggots over that line every time, every cast. But also thinking about topping up, but I'm just looking round and thinking, at the moment, there ain't a lot being caught. And we're all, you know, there's a lot of people fishing in the same area as what I am. So at the moment, I'm doing all right. So I'm a bit like, you know, that's what I'm thinking as well. That wind is quite awkward at the moment. It's like left to right, slightly in my face. And it's trying to stop the float from just inching through. I'm just hoping that the wind doesn't affect, you know, what I don't want is the tow to go the same way as the wind, because that won't be good at all. at the moment it is just trying to go back, which is what we want. And that float is sitting there, absolutely beautiful. Not great bites. I've got a bit of float showing, more than probably normal. But it is a sensitive float, to be fair. I'm also thinking as well, you know, if this line keeps producing and there ain't a lot else being caught, I've also got to look after them other lines. You know, I've got to think about topping them up. I can't just leave it. And that's what's going through my mind all the time when I'm fishing these sort of matches. You know, topping up the other lines, even though I'm not fishing them. But at the moment, I'm just going to concentrate on this line. Have a quick look around now and again, see what's being caught. And this is already different from when I fished 2 weeks ago, because I caught very little on this line last 2 weeks ago. I never actually had a bite there early. I actually only caught a few fish. They were a good bream at the end of the match, but I never caught early. And today it's different. I've caught some fish there early. So obviously everything, it's all being, you know, it's all going in my mind. I've got my top up mix ready to go. A few pinkies, bit of caster, a few dead maggots in it. But last time I come, I just felt the more pinkies I put in, the better the bait, the better the fishing got, really. And that's obviously stuck in my mind. Whether that's going to be the same today, I don't know, but all I know from 2 weeks ago to today, there were several people 2 weeks ago catching really well at the start, and that ain't happening today. Everyone is sort of slow. You can see them sat there. There's an odd person striking, but there ain't a lot coming out. Little lift bite there. Oh, a little tiny fish that was. And I think that's going to give me the... I think that's the sort of telling me that I need to put another little ball in. That's what I felt then. That was a tiny little fish. I'm gonna put another little ball in there. Not very big. Size of a golf ball. A few pinkies, a couple of casters, a couple of dead maggots. And then go straight on it. Because I'm just watching around me and seen a couple of people go on their 13 meter lines. And it ain't really happening. Interesting now to see how long it takes me to get a bite, if I get a bite. But like I said, when I'm fishing at like 10 meters like that, I've not set nothing up shorter. Because I don't know the place. I think the roach that I seen caught 2 weeks ago, most of the roach were caught over in the shallow water. They never really caught anything short. If anybody did catch short, they were like I did. I caught late and I caught some bream. I did catch a couple of roach, admittedly. But that's why I'm loose feeding a little bit short and on me float. Because I can drop back if I want to. If I want to get away from me ground bait. But like I said, realistically, to do any good, you're going to need some bream, some skimmers. There we go, indication then, see? So that's right on that ball, so that's pretty good. But topping up. Indication, which I missed it, admittedly, but at least I've had an indication topping up. A few maggots. And obviously, you know, the water is absolutely freezing. I've not got a thermometer with me, but I bet it's only like 6 degrees, 6-7 degrees. There we go. That's brilliant. Topping it up. Not a very big fish, admittedly, but at least it was on that top-up ball. Feels like a Percy the Perch, that. No, Rudd. Bob Nudd. What's Bob Nudd doing about? But that was over the top of that ball, so that's good. And that's something now. I'm taking in all that information in, because that's going to help me, not just on this line, but on them other lines as well. Because sooner or later, I will have to top them up. And if I topped up and absolutely nothing happened after the start I had, I'd be very dubious about topping them lines up too early. But what I don't want to do is, like, if there's fish over there settled and I'm still catching on this line, I will think about putting an odd little ball in there, even though I'm not fishing it. And a lot of people don't think like that. And on the day, that can cost you dearly. Well, we've been going now just over an hour and 5 minutes. And it's all right. I've caught some lovely roach. I've had one of them, like that big skimmer at the start. A couple of other skimmers, but looking around at the moment, there ain't many skimmers being caught or bream. So I've got to bear that in mind. I'm catching some nice roach over that ground bait short. But I'm itching to have a look on that 13 metre line just in case there is a few bonus fish around. But like I said at the start, you never know. I said the matches are being won here with big weight some weeks and other weeks. You know, like I think 16 pound won it the other day. So that's going to make a big difference of what you do and what you catch. But I think in a minute, I'm going to have a go on that 13 metre line just to see if there is a bonus bream or a big skimmer about, because I don't want to miss that opportunity. It's a bit of a gamble because I am catching an odd fish on this line. Still loose feeding a few maggots. Guy to my right is fishing over now. He's actually got a little cap pot on. And he's catching some roach right over. Well, not right over, but probably 4 foot of water. So that's something else that I've noticed. So I'm always looking for that. I think it's a big roach. No, it's a bit deeper where he is. It's deep where he is, right over. It's different to my peg. I seen him plumb up this morning. I did say to him, your peg's really deep over, and that might make a big difference today. But I'm still catching some nice roach in the deep water there. And I think that's a hybrid, what he's got on there. But all that, you know, all that's been in. So I've got that rig set up for fishing 16 metres, because it is wide in this area, which is probably like 5 foot of water, just in case. But I'm definitely going to top this up again in a minute and just have a little look at 13 metres. But the guy to my right did fish it like 11 or 13 metres, and he's only caught a couple of fish on it. It was really, really slow. But one thing for certain, at the moment, there's not many bream or big skimmers coming out at the moment. But they could switch on. It, you know, bear basically 2 weeks ago, I didn't catch nothing for over an hour. But my match was different. My match was, I never went over for an hour, and when I did catch. It's completely the opposite at the moment. There's some roach coming out at the other end, but there was a lot of roach caught there last time up the end of the lake. Just feels inside I need to top that up now. Even though I'm still catching an odd fish. It ain't quick by any means, you know what I mean? I'm getting a bite every chuck, but I've got to be patient. It does feel like I need to put a little ball in again now. I had a little tiny sort of 2 ounce fish, the last fish I caught. He's definitely catching a few right over now, just cab potting maggots in, I think. Hard work mine, but you know, if it's a hard day like today and the skimmers and bream ain't feeding, then I think that's gonna, you know, it's gonna be a good shout. It's only a little roach, probably 3 ounces. That's definitely gone a bit there. So I'm going to top that up. And then just have a quick look on my 13 metre line. So I'm going to put another little ball. Probably a little bit bigger this time. Just a bit bigger than what I fed there. On my first top up, because I'm not going to be on it for probably 10 minutes. I'm hoping that 13 metre line has got a few decent fish on it. You never know. So it's same rig. Just go over with a big maggot on, because that maggot's been pretty good, to be fair. I just need to sort this pole out a bit. So 13 metre plus the dolly. Wind's awkward though, because the wind's smacking your face. It's turned round already. Right, let's have a little look, see if there's anything on that line. Said same float, 0.75. Nice and positive. Because of the depth, really. And I learned a bit from 2 weeks ago. I just felt I fished slightly too light of rigs, really. Fished half a grams and I should have fished 0.75. I'm expecting it to go, you know, really, I'm expecting that to be pretty quick for a response after leaving it for over an hour. Ooh, it was a little indication then. Hopefully a big liner off of a bream. Just loose feed that. Short line as well, keep that going. Thing is, as well, with that wind like that, it's going to make it really awkward to catapult long. Might be the case I have to put a little pot on the end of my pole, because with it in your face like that, it's just going to go everywhere. I think I've had two indications. And he's catching well over, roach. And if it's going to be a low weight match, it's definitely consider, you know, potting in a few maggots on my long, long line. Well, don't seem to be a lot there. A bit gutted about that, to be honest, because I thought that would be. But obviously, if the skimmers and bream ain't feeding, that's probably why. because there ain't many quality fish coming out at the moment. Really surprised at that, actually. Not a sign. Well, I've had one sign, I think. Well, it's not good at all, that. I'm actually going to top that up now. Even though I ain't caught on it, I'm going to put another little ball in there. And I'm also going to feed my long line, which is right over. So I'm going to put another little ball in on that line, even though I haven't caught on it. No point just come off of it and not topping up, because I need to have the confidence of going back on it later and think, well, I looked after it. And I'm also going to top up my long line, which was something we didn't really talk about, but it's right over in like 16 meters, but I've got a real wide peg, so I ain't got a lot of choice. I'm just going to put a little bit of loose ground bait in and some loose maggots. I'm just going to have a quick go before I come back down that middle. Just a quick go on that line that I put up the shelf. This is about 6 foot of water. Just to make sure, one, it ain't solid with fish. Well, just to find out if there's any fish there, really. Because that's the line that I caught on 2 weeks ago, and it was really, really good. So I'm on the line now where I put the 3 pots of loose on, which is up the shelf. Only about a metre and a half past. There we go, there's a bite straight away then. And this is what happened 2 weeks ago. They felt like they wanted to be on that shelf where I drew anyway. Go, little roach, I think. So that's only a metre and a half away, and I've had 2 bites straight away. Need a little fish. 3-ounce roach. And that's really strange, because that's what happened to me last 2 weeks ago, is like I fed literally a metre and a half up the shelf. And that's where I caught all my fish, or most of my fish anyway. Oh, definitely a few fish on that line, so that's good. I can't loose feed it. I'd love to loose feed it, but I can't with that wind in my face. I'll have to put a little pot on, or I just use the big pot. I don't really want to use a little pot, really. But if I need to, I'll have to. Like I said, that's on the line that I put that. That's up the shelf, on the shelf. There we go. And that is a bream, I think. Which is amazing when you think the 13 metre line, which is virtually the same depth as my 10 metre line, I caught absolutely nothing. And it felt like there was nothing there. Going to concentrate a minute, because these fish today, if it's going to fish hard, these will be crucial. So I said, that's like 6 foot of water. I actually caught in deeper water last time, but it was closer to the bank. It was definitely plumbed up. It plumbed up different to my peg where I am today. It feels like a good skimmer, eh? And they do have scrap in here for skimmers, I'll tell you. Look at that. Well, that's not really a skimmer, that's more like a bream. Ooh, look at that. Not happy. That'll do. Probably 2, 2.5 pound. I mean, what's that doing up the shelf like that? But that just shows you. Single red maggot. 16 SFL. Said six, all six elastics. I got a 16, sorry, a 4B16 F1 maggot on there. So this is the line I showed you when I got my little pen mark on my pole, so I know exactly where I'm fishing on that shelf. And like I said, you can use a pen or a bit of electrical tape. But I do fancy putting a little pot on there and just cab potting over the top some maggots, and maybe even putting some ground bait in with a little pot. There you go, straight away, another little fish. Nice little dumpy roach. It's always gambles, because I always think now, oh, I wish I put a bit more. When you go onto a line and you catch, you think, oh, I wish I put some more ground bait in, you know, so you don't have to top up so much. But you never know from day to day. It's all gambles how much you put in at the start. But that's nice there. I can see me float nice as well there. There's definitely some roach in that over there in that shallow water. But never forget, all I'm thinking about is my other lines. You know, that 10 metre line, if I carry on catching like this, I'll drop back in on that. I might not even go on it, but I'll feed it again. Got to look after it. Got to. Even the lines I haven't really caught on now and again, that 13 metre line later on in the match, I might have to go on it if it's absolutely pants everywhere else. Lovely fish in that. Only 4 ounce roach. So I've had a couple of nice bonus bream. Definitely doing all right, I would have thought. Zolt will tell me if I'm doing all right. He's nodding his head, yes. And it's fishing quite hard. It's fishing probably, it's probably fishing like what I call a nice match. No one's running away with it. I mean, I obviously would like to be running away with it, but I'm not. Oh, hello. Hello. Another bream. Amazing, isn't it, that them fish can be over that shelf like that. I'm afraid you cannot beat an F1 maggot float. Doesn't matter where I go, what I do. I probably wish they'd done a 4B18 because I'd probably be fishing one of them down the middle in that deep water if they'd done one. Another nice fish show. That feels like a right unit, that. So you can just imagine all that like loose ground bit. I've probably put it over, it's probably spread over an area of like a, probably like a half of a car bonnet, if you like. Look at that. That's the ones you want. Tang around his fin, but I don't mind. They don't fight when they're tang around their fin. A nice bream, that. Oh, yes. These are the match winners. Hello. Probably £4, that. Like that. Well, a bit of an update. I think we're in like halfway through now. And I was catching roach really well on that 16 meter line. And it just slowed up a little bit, even though I was getting odd bite. And I thought, well, I need to try that 14 meter line again. Obviously that's the line I put that loose ground bait in. But I've changed the cab potting maggots as well on that line, same as the 16 meter line. And I've had a £4 bream and I've had some roach as well. And I've just, because that's what I want to do, because I've not caught a skimmer or a bream across, it's 16. But I've obviously caught two other bream, plus the one I just caught at 14 and a half. And I think that's where I'm going to get me bonus fish at the moment, if I'm going to get one. There's a few skimmers coming out. But at the moment, I think there's a lot of roach being caught, but not so many skimmers and bream. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to go between 14 and a half and 16 at the moment. Give myself a chance of catching a bream at 14 and a half, as well as some roach. But if it goes dead, I'm going to put like half a pot of loose in and then go back to 16. Because I can catch roach. They don't seem to want to settle in deep water, these roach. You get an odd one, but it's not as quick as 16. It's 16, I mean, it literally is quick, it's the quickest line, but there don't seem to be any sort of big bonus fish. I've had a roach a pound over there, to be fair. It's a beautiful roach, absolutely stunning. But that 14 and a half is like where I'm thinking I'll make the most of it. I might get a little bit lucky and catch a bream or a skimmer, which is going to be really important today, as well as all these roach, because these roach are, I mean, they're not little. Woo, 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 woo. That was bad angling. They're like 3 to 4 ounces. Still on single maggot, potting in some maggots on that 14 and a half meter line as well, but not every chuck, every sort of 4 or 5 fish. It's sort of too slow really to mess about cad potting all the time. I want to get in and get some fish out. You know, you're going to need a decent weight today. I would estimate you're probably going to want 25 to 35 pounds to probably get in the top 3, I would have thought. which is mega fishing. That's good fishing, that. Definitely better cad potting maggots, though, 100%. Lovely fishing. Nice 6-ounce roach. So you're sort of trying to calculate, really. You start, you know, look at that. 8 ounces, that. You don't need many of them to catch a bream or a skimmer. So I'm gonna put a cad pot again this time. So that's been like 4 or 5 fish. Just got a small cad pot on. And just putting as many maggots as I can in it. Dipping it in the water just to stop them coming out on the way out. I can ship out a lot quicker like that, which is what I want. It is a bit of speed fishing involved as well with this. So I've got my little black mark. I can bring it to, tap my maggots out. Just drop my rig straight down, bulk straight on top of it. It's nice when the wind's blowing that angle. When it blows in my face, it sort of feels like it's blowing it off the shelf. It's not easy, though. Not easy when that wind gets up. You know, I was hoping that it was all going to be sort of short fishing, but I think the pressure, you know, they've had quite a lot of matches on here now. The fish have been caught quite a lot. And it does have an effect. It's so obvious. Oh, I just lost that. And that's all I'm doing. Once I come off of this line, I will put like 1/2 to 3/4 of a pot of loose ground bait in with some pinkies, a few casters, leave it, go on that 16, keep my eye out. There is a few skimmers being caught short, but not enough to, it doesn't seem enough to compete with what I'm doing. It's like they're not catching quick enough because the roach I'm catching is sort of outnumbering all that on weight. But, you know, most importantly, I'm having an awesome day's fishing, which is what it's all about. I'm still loose feeding that short line. I've put a little ball in there. Obviously, I need to look after that. Now and again, every sort of 30 minutes or 40 minutes, I will put another little ball in there, so I might have to drop on that late. Yeah, that went dead then. That's a good fish. I think that's a big roach, that. It's quite coloured, this water. It's put me off of caster fishing, really. When I looked at it 2 weeks ago, I thought it's a bit dirty. Oh, yes. That's what I mean. You start getting a few roaches like that. I mean, that other one I had, that's probably 9 ounces. 10 ounces. It'd be a fool, really, to start messing around too much. You know, them two fish alone would have gone over a pound. Definitely seems on that line, though, when you go in on it after leaving it, it's like there's a lot of fish there and it dries up really quick. It's like they're over and then they drop back. Definitely going to feed that again in a minute. Just going to. The only problem is I've got, if that wind gets so much lot stronger at 16 metres, that will be an absolute nightmare. Definitely going to feed that again. Put another 1/2 pot of, feed that and have a quick, another look on that 16 metre line. And hopefully they'll be there. Few maggots in with a bit of loose ground bait. just going to drop. Just drop a little ball in at that 10 meter line as well, just to keep that ticking over. Just get me 16 meter piece on. Just go back onto that 16 meter section now, or that 16 meter line. I put a few maggots in straight away. Like I said, I put half a pot of ground bait on that line as well, which is nice because it feels like you can leave it. They're going to sit over that ground bait. And obviously you can see why I put that so natural roach in, because the roach are going to make a big difference today. Unless I've done it completely wrong, I get battered. Lovely, straight into a nice roach. So I'm going to keep going on that now, and then probably go exactly the same. Give it like 20 minutes, half an hour, unless this dries up, and then just go back onto that 14 meter line. Definitely settled over there, right? Definitely in that shallow water. Lot of roach over there. Just cab pot again. Really enjoyable though, real nice fishing. Well, we've got about an hour to go now, and as you can probably tell by the film, the wind's got up a little bit, and the 16 meter line is still my best line. I've actually caught two skimmers over there as well, like probably one about a pound, one about a pound and a half, just out of the blue really. Didn't do anything different, just tapping in maggots. But I've just come back now and dropped on me 14.5 meter line just to see if I can catch another bream or something. But to be honest, there's definitely not, there's a few skimmers coming out, but I'm catching roach so well, I think I'm sort of keeping up and overtaking them people that are catching a few skimmers, because I've had a couple of skimmers myself, but they just don't seem to want to come in numbers. They don't want to seem to come, or the fish don't seem to want to be coming off the bank very far. I mean, that 14.5 meter that I'm on at the moment, I've just dropped in and caught a nice roach, but then nothing again, just sat there. But my 16 meter line, like inside 4 foot of water, is really, really good. It is literally a bite every chuck. But it just slowed down a bit before I started talking again. And I've just put another like half a pot of loose ground bait in, because I have caught them two skimmers, and I'm thinking, right, let me just see. Let me just leave it for 5-10 minutes. But I'm still looking, I've to be fair, the 30 meter line, I've sort of forgot about, because I had no confidence with that. I mean, I fed two lines at 13, went on the one quite early, and it was just like nothing there. And the lines that I've caught on, it's been pretty instant when I've gone there, and there's been some fish in me peg. Now, if it had been fishing absolutely terrible, I probably would have had to just stick it out and sort of try and get a bite maybe at 13, but I've sort of sacked it off. Another little roach then at 14.5. So I'm just concentrating, really. Still putting an odd ball in at 10 metres. Oh, that's come off. But just concentrating on those two lines, 14.5 and 16. And to be honest, I can't see me going or staying on this 14.5 metre line much, because it just, unless there's an odd big one there, the wind's really awkward on that line as well, because I'm fishing right on that steep shelf. I'm sort of just going past me pole mark to make sure I'm on the bottom. But I'm having a mega day. I've had some great big roach, you know, obviously a couple of nice big bream. Just looking around, and there ain't, you know, everybody sort of, we're getting an odd fish, but not quick. And I thought that 14.5 meter line was, you know, when I went on it, it was quite good. I can get a bite on it, but it's just not the same as 16. And I'm just trying, and hopefully I can catch another bream there. I said, I've not forgot about that 10 meter line, because I might have to use that late. But it's not giving me a lot of confidence when I look around the lake and people ain't catching loads of fish in deep water. That's lovely there, and it's just not really happening. I did actually feed it. Oh, that's a lift bite, I think. Oh, there might be a bream, there might be a skimmer there. I thought I was a liner then. I did give it like 3/4 of a pot of loose ground bait and a few more pinkies before I went, last time I come off of this line, just to think I want to try and get a skimmer or a bream in me peg again. I'm sure that was a little liner, that was a little lift bite. But I have poked it up the shelf a little bit, because I just want to make sure I'm on the bottom. That wind's getting nasty now, look. But even them roach won't settle there. There we go. No, I don't know what that is. But I definitely had a little liner. I'm hoping that's a skimmer, but it might be a... Yeah, I think it is a skimmer, so that's good. That's what I was hoping for, really. I'm just, you know, I know I can fall back on that 16 meter line and catch, but I also want to give myself a chance of catching some bonus fish. Yeah, nice big skimmer. They do have scrap in here. There's a few of these coming out, but not enough to sort of compete with the roach as well. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful then. So that's a nice little bonus coming back on that line. Let's see if I can get another one. And to be honest, I think that line there is a bit like the roach ain't there because there's a few skimmers about. Well, that's what it seems like. And I think both times, actually two of the skimmers that I caught over, the peg went a little bit funny for a few minutes. Be nice to get a few of them rock up in that last hour. There's a lot of roach being caught today. I think the colour's gone out of it a bit and the roach have had a go. It's really hard to sort of judge because you don't want to leave it. It's hard work fishing 16, admittedly, but the size of the roach you're catching, it's worth the hard work. Everybody's getting some bites. Just want this to go under now with another nice big bream on with a bit of luck. But the roach are definitely, like, numbers of roach are definitely in that shallower water. They're not settling at all, even in that 6 foot of water I'm fishing. It's never felt like they're there settled. Where it's 16, you know, I fed exactly the same ground bait and maggots and they're there in numbers. And you virtually get a bite of chuck, even though it's a lot harder to fish over there. There you go. Another big skimmer, I think. Now, again, I got a little line, little indication, just think. If that was F1 fishing, I'd have probably struck at that, but I left it because I thought it was a liner. So that gamble, you know, putting like 3/4 of a pot of ground bait in there again with a few particles is paid off and leaving it like 20 minutes. That 6 is absolutely perfect for a day like today. That's what's so good about it. You can catch your roach, your skimmers, your bonus fish. Oh yes. Beautiful, look at that. Absolutely stunning, aren't they? So, let me get back out again, see if I can get another one, hopefully. I don't know, to be honest. I would have thought it would have been close, wouldn't I? But this is where you're like, you know, it's like I've always said to people, this is where your top of the range poles come in. When you've got to fish a venue like this, you know, windy, you've got to fish long, it makes a huge difference. Obviously, as the year goes on, it will change. You won't have to fish long. You'll probably be catching these short, out of your hand. But with the cold weather and the pressure, you can catch fish. It feels like you can get an odd bite everywhere in your peg, but it's getting them, it's catching them the quickest and the most efficient way, and it ain't short. And that's exactly what happened to me 2 weeks ago. if I sat short, I would eventually get a bite, but it was, you were never going to compete. That feels like a proper unit. I just hope it's in the mouth. Oh, I reckon that was fouled up. Gutted. I'm just going to take one of those little shot off again. I couldn't quite see me float then. Felt like a big skimmer as well, that. Nice. If the wind stayed like that, you can see your float absolutely perfect. It's when you get that little bit of ripple on it. I've just noticed there's a few more skimmers coming out now. A couple of people have started catching skimmers, so they might have just actually come on the feed. It's a roach. Big lift bite that was. Yeah, I've got, I'm on one a day. Yeah. Have you? Six a day. That's a lot, isn't it? Hey? Sorry, we're just having a chat about medical problems. Yeah, it's messed things up, hasn't it? Definitely got to go a bit careful now with what I do, because if there's some bream and skimmers feeding. Yeah. No, well, that's what happened to me. I had to go... Well... It was like I had indigestion. It's unbelievable, really. So I just got to try and play this. That's right, that's all it matters, isn't it? I just got to play this a little bit careful now, because obviously, if there is some bream and skimmers about, I'm a bit gutted that I lost that one, but I think it was fouled up. So we got, probably got just under an hour to go now. I also don't want to stay here too long trying to catch a skimmer or two when I know my roach line at 16 is really, really good. I won't give it too long either. If I don't get one in the next sort of 5 minutes, I'm going to put another dose of ground bait in there, like half a pot of loose, little, you know, a few particles in it, a few casters, some pinkies. I would like to put a ball in there, but it just feels like it's going to run down the shelf, which is absolutely pointless, because then you don't know what's happening. At least with that loose, I think, well, I'm over it and it's there. There might be a little bit of it sort of trundling down the slope. It's not a massive slope. It's not really aggressive, but it's aggressive enough for me not to put a ball in. It's just started towing a little bit now. It's a bit sort of picked up. Oh, look at that. That was either a liner or a roach bite, I think. Just feels like I'm gonna get another one, eh? There we go. Roach this time, eh? Lovely bite, eh? Brilliant when you can catch, you know, even the roach are quality fish. They're not like tiny. They're all weight builders. Try a double maggot. I haven't put any worms in today. I brought some worms with me. I've not really heard of anybody catching on worms, anything like that. So it sort of put me off really. But it won't be long. If this weather stays like it is, worms would probably be very, very good. Well, it'd be one or the other. You never know with worms. Worms can be absolutely brilliant or a kiss of death. And that's probably why I didn't put them in. I just wanted to stay with what I got, which is like pinkish casters and maggots, and obviously my ground bait. But it won't be long before I'm sure you'll put worms in this venue and they'll be gagging for it. Just feels like I'm gonna get another skimmer any second. Just like I said, just starting to creep along a bit for a bit stronger now, the tow. I think with that wind, it's sort of got the lake going a little bit. It's just definitely going through a little bit faster than what it was. Just feels like there's one there. I just had another little indication then, like a real fast, not a bite either, like a liner. But as you can probably tell from the, you know, from the film now, there's no ropes there really. It's nothing like the 16 metre line. 16 metre line is much, much different to this line. So I reckon let's just see what happens this cast, and definitely gonna feed this again and just go back on that 16 and drop back in on this with like probably half an hour to go. Because they're not settling, definitely not settling. Another little tiny indication then. That's what's keeping me on it, because I think there's one there. Yeah, I've roached that. I reckon I'm going to feed that. Just to make sure I stay ahead of the game, really, because I know I can catch roach a lot quicker. It's 16. Let's have one more go. Just to satisfy my mind that there's not another skimmer there. There we go. I needed to satisfy my mind. I've just nailed another skimmer, I think. Just had a gut feeling I was gonna get one. Really do scrappo. For skimmers. Oh, that's a little bit bigger, that one. You know, this is your make or break time really in matches. I mean, I've had an awesome day. It's been hard work because I've had to fish long on the pole, but you know, some days you've got to do it. That one's probably a pound and three quarters. Look at the condition of them. Double maggot. Gotta have another go. Got about 14 minutes to go, and I've, since I last spoke to you, I went over on 16 meter line. I've had two skimmers and a few roach, but I just obviously I've fed this 14 and a half meter line again, and I've left it there, we go, because I just, you look around the lake and all of a sudden there's a few people catching bream and skimmers really well now, and I thought, well, I've done all right up to now, but I'm going to need to sort of give myself a chance of catching some bream or skimmers. So I didn't go on that 60, I didn't stay on it for long. I caught two little skimmers on 16 meters and a couple of roach, but I'm like, I'm back on my 14 and a half meter line now, because looking around, there's quite a lot of quality skimmers coming out. And I feel like I've been ahead all day. And what I don't want to do is sort of, well, it's all gambles, I know, but I'm not catching. I've had some nice bream early, a couple, but there's a few people catching some proper, you know, proper big bream, like the ones I had earlier. So that's back on my 14 and a half meter line. I actually put a little ball in and a bit of loose, and I made the ball so it literally went down probably a couple of feet or so before it broke up. And I've left it, I said to Zolt, I'm gonna leave that for 10 minutes, whatever's happened at 16, because I need to give myself a chance of, you know, catching what I just caught then. And hopefully, they definitely come on that feeder the last hour. There's quite a few people catching them now. The guy down here has had like quite a few big fish on the end down there. I think it's gonna be close. I'm just hoping that the roach that I've had sort of throughout the match will sort of top the scales, and hopefully, well, whatever happens, I've had a mega day's fishing anyway, but I'm very competitive, and I love doing well. And that literally, that was my first chuck on my 14 and a half, and I had a liner. It definitely, you get a few liners when there's some in your peg. And then I've got to make a decision now with like 10 minutes to go, whether I actually top it up again, but I'm not sure. But this, fingers crossed that I can get another one or two decent skimmers on that line, which will keep me, you know, keep me in front. It's hard to tell though, because like, you don't know how big the bream in that are, that other people have caught. If they're then like 4 pounders, you don't need many fish to catch a big weight. Just gonna lift and drop a little bit. There's probably two people, I reckon, two or three people that could possibly sort of beat me, I reckon, looking around. And that'd be because of the weight of, well, the size of bream, I think. I could be completely wrong, but when I see them in the landing nets, they do look really big. thought I just had a little tiny liner then. But it's hard to tell with the bit of tow and a little bit of wind on it. It just felt like it just dipped a little bit. And it ain't a day to strike it, that. You know, it ain't like a, it's not like fishing for F1s today. If you get them skimmers and your bream in your peg, some venues you get them tiny, tiny little indications. But here today, you've got to wait a little bit, otherwise you're striking it liners. See, I've had that one, and then I'm sort of itching to top up again now. I think I might have to top up before we finish. Yeah, I think I'm going to top up. Zoltz just told me there's 7 minutes to go, so if I top up now, at least I get the last 5 minutes. Or I might be able to catch another one. Yeah, let's get another little ball in there, a little soft ball. I was a bit gutted with that actually, because I thought they were going to be there then. So I'm going to put another tiny little ball in, a little bit of loose, and then go straight on it. Bit of luck. I've got 5 minutes to go. Let's see if I can catch another one. The wind's getting up as well. The only thing is, I didn't put as much in. When I had that little run of skimmer, I had like three there. And when I come off of it, because I thought I'd go back on it quick, I didn't put that much bait in. I'd probably put like 3/4 of a pot of loose in again. But I didn't, because I thought I'm gonna come on it pretty quick. So I might have messed things up there a little bit. So we've got like five minutes to go now. But I'll run through, while we got a couple of minutes to go, I'll run through the summary. Basically what I've done, just to sort of clear everything up, is the, you know, what I learned 2 weeks ago was, which was really like weird, that all the fish I caught, or most of my weight I caught where I didn't think I was going to catch, which was up the shelf, slightly shallower water. And it's been the same today, really. Probably a bit worse today actually, because there's been, everything has been like, oh yeah, here we go. Sorry about that. So putting that ball in, that's just what the doctor ordered. And then putting that one ball in short, I probably caught more than anybody short at the start, which was good. You know, I've got to start somewhere. I put the two balls in, two lines at 13, went on that, and it was just like, nah, not a bite. Then obviously come back to 10 meters, that didn't really happen. And then it's just been a case of like your 14 and a half meter line, which has been the best line for bonus fish. But the 16 meter line's been the best line by far for roach. And it's depths of water. So I've caught all my bream and skimmers, most of them, in 6 foot. And I've caught all my roach in 4 foot. Nice skimmer, eh? Just not as... Oh, I don't believe it. What an absolute gutter. That was me pulling too hard. That could be costly. Gutted. And that's the only skimmer I've lost today. I've lost a couple fouled up. But that's the first one I've actually lost in the mouth. What a gutter. If you lot wouldn't have been watching, I'd have probably said a few words then, which I shouldn't have. But I thought it was pretty good then. But yeah, gutted. What an absolute gutter. And I won't be happy if that costs me. That was such a beautiful bite as well. Just glided away. Oh, I just thought a little tiny indication then. But it's really difficult fishing on that shelf, and that's why that little black mark I've got on there, it helps you out massively. Some people, like I said, some people, like earlier in the film, some people put a little bit of electrical tape around it. And you can actually feel it on your hand then, you can know where you're fishing. Come on, one more. But whatever happens, I've had a fantastic day's fishing. It doesn't get better. It's quite a new lake, this. It has been fished quite a bit recently, and you can tell now that the fish have wised up. A lot of the fish, I think, have moved across. There we go. That's the end of the match. So that skimmer was my last chance. So anyway, hopefully we'll follow the scales round, see what's been caught. Fingers crossed. I think I've done all right. I'm not sure I've done enough to sort of win, but I'll be there or thereabout. So what we'll do, we'll follow the scales around, I think, or we might just steer and wait for the results. And fingers crossed, I've done enough to stay in front. Looking at it, I'm there or thereabouts, but that skimmer could cost me, but we'll find out in just a few minutes. What can I say? What a fantastic day's fishing I've had at Harescombe on their new silverfish lake. I've had 48.1, I think. So I've had some bream, loads of roach. Look at some of the quality of the fish there. It's unreal. I thought I had a little bit more in that, actually, but the roach haven't weighed as much as what I thought. But I have fished 16 meters, so it feels like you're catching loads and loads, but it's just steady away. So there you go. I don't know how I've got on. There's been a 20-odd pound down there. I think there'd be some bigger weights up there. But what we'll do, I'll get these back. Obviously, really important to get them back. And just before I leave, I'll let you know the result. And fingers crossed, I've got in the top two or three. But I don't care because I've had an awesome day's fishing. Let's get them back. Well, we finished weighing in now, and I've actually come second with 48 pounds of silverfish. There's been a 67 pound of bream on the opposite side, so well done to him. We've had a mega day's fishing, and if you've enjoyed the video as much as I've enjoyed the fishing, then we've done our job. I hope you've picked up some tips. You know, really, really important today when you're fishing on that slope, whether you're fishing for carp or bream, try putting that like loose ground bait in. It makes a massive difference. Unfortunately, I just felt today, with it being that steep, putting balls in on that slope wasn't right. I wish I could, because I think I could have topped up with little balls and maybe caught some more skimmers. But I have had a fantastic day's fishing. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button on the Preston YouTube channel, and thanks for watching.